DARPA's Liberty Lifter Project Ekranoplan concept, X-plane being developed for U.S. Armed Forces. The Pentagon's latest vision for a flying transport that is able to operate from water. The Ekranoplan, somewhere between a boat and a plane. Designed to glide at high speed over the surface of the water, by making use of ground effect, Ekranoplans have so far found only very limited military usage, notably in the former Soviet Union, and it would mark a truly innovative departure if adopted by the U.S. Armed Forces. The Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, or DARPA, has launched its Liberty Lifter project that aims to create a long-range, low-cost X-plane using the Ekranoplan concept. The agency wants the craft to demonstrate seaborne strategic and tactical lift and says that the project should demonstrate a leap in operational logistics capabilities. In a media release, DARPA explains, the envisioned plane will combine fast and flexible strategic lift of very large, heavy loads with the ability to take off and land in water. Its structure will enable both highly controlled flight close to turbulent water surfaces and sustained flight at mid-altitudes. In addition, the plane will be built with a low-cost design and construction philosophy. Currently, the program is in its initial phase, which involves defining the unique seaplane's range, payloads, and other parameters, according to Alexander Wallen, a program manager in DARPA's Tactical Technology Office. However, Wallen also speaks confidently of the program's goal to showcase an X-plane demonstrator that offers warfighters new capabilities during extended maritime operations. The fact that the Liberty Lifter should be able to operate not only by skimming over the surface of the water, but also at mid-altitudes, of up to 10,000 feet, indicates that the craft will actually be a hybrid, combining the key advantages of an Ekranoplan with the superior performance attributes and flexibility of a conventional fixed-winged aircraft. All this thinking is clearly based on the potential for a future conflict with China in the Asia-Pacific region. Here, likely contingencies would be dominated by the maritime environment, would involve moving cargoes and personnel over huge distances, and would see conventional airfields threatened from the outset by China's powerful long-range strike assets. These concerns have led to significant shifts in the way the entire U.S. military expects it may have to fight in the future, and aerial transport, especially in the maritime domains of the Asia-Pacific, has been a part of this new thinking. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.